to day three of our 31 days of prayer, rebuilding the church after COVID-19 assimilation. The scriptures for today are James 1 verse 5. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. Philippians 2, 3 to 4. Let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. Let each of you look out not only for his own interest, but also for the interest of others. Father, thank you for the church, the body of Christ. Thank you for the giftings and abilities you have placed within each of us to edify and build up one another for your glory. Jesus, you said you would not leave us as orphans when you went to the Father. You gave us your Holy Spirit, our helper who would be with us forever. What an incomprehensible and reassuring truth to ponder and live. Father, we ask for holy, inspired wisdom to equip us as we, your church, co-labor according to your will. In the past several months, we've learned to do church a whole different way. You've given us wisdom to accomplish that through many new means. Thank you, Lord. Now give us wisdom as we reconnect. Thank you that many thousands of people have tuned in for the first time and made commitments to follow you during online church services. Now we ask that you cause them to hunger and thirst for righteousness. Help them get established in a local Bible preaching church and the body of Christ. Help them put down deep roots in your word and help them grow like healthy plants in good soil into the fullness of your calling for them. Father, it is your desire that we connect with one another to encourage love, strengthen, and to bless the body of Christ. Take away all the fear from our hearts that would in any way keep us from reconnecting in our churches. We need one another. You have told us that the perfect love casts out fear. Give me so much love for my brothers and sisters in Christ that fear would not be present when we join together in prayer and worship. Holy Spirit, speak to every heart. Use this season to develop depth and your purpose in the body of Christ. Cause your church to shine as a beacon of light for all to see. Draw the lost to your light. Assimilate them into the body. As we come together, let us do as the Apostle Paul instructs us and be unwavering in our love and devotion for one another. Help us understand and pray for one another. Help us show the world what it means to live for the Lord. It's so easy to get caught up in the political factions taking place. It's so easy to take sides regarding the news of the day. The enemy would love to divide us, but not on my watch. I will not be a tool of the enemy, but a vessel for the Father's use. Father, forgive me for not loving my church family as I ought. Forgive me for allowing fear to rule my heart rather than the peace of God. Forgive me for allowing my own personal interests to be more important than the needs of my spiritual family. Work out of me, self, so that you can use me for the benefit of others, so that you will be exalted. People need Jesus. Help me to not miss any opportunity to minister Christ to others. In Jesus' holy name I pray, amen.